Good morning, Mandan. Today we are going to discuss about properties of the ROC for Z transform, region of convergence, right? This is the assumption we are going to consider for these properties. We assume specifically that the algebraic expression for the Z transform is a rational function. Rational function means we are simply assuming that x of z equal to p of z by q of z, where p of z and q of z are some polynomials. That's what the assumption we are going to consider for these kind of properties. And that x of n has finite amplitude except possibly at n equal to infinity or n equal to minus infinity. Already explained the reason for this last one. Why except at n equal to infinity or minus infinity means, for example, I'll consider x of n equals to 2 power n into u of n. Just for example, yeah, can you reply to me what is the z transform for this? Yeah, can you please respond? Yeah, what is the z transform for this? 1 by 1
minus 2 into z inverse.
Yes, and this incomplete,
mod,
right?
Mod z.
Yeah, mod z should be greater than 2. We have z transform for this one with an ROC, region of convergence, mod z greater than 2. That's what we got finally, right? Now, what is the value of this x of n at infinity? X of n at, okay, as n tends to infinity. What is this value? 2 power infinity. What is this value? Anything above 1, whole power infinity. What is this? It's infinite, right? For example, if I consider 0.1 whole power infinity, 10 power minus infinity is 0. If I have something above 1, 2 power infinity, that leads to infinity. It's increasing sequence, right? For example, consider 2. 2 into 2 is 4. 2 into 2 into 2 is 8. 16 and so on. This is an increasing sequence, right? If I do till infinity, then that will become infinite, right? It's increasing till infinity. That's what we are having, right? We have x of n equals to infinity as n tends to infinity. That's exception, right? Still, we are able to find z transform for that one. That's why we mentioned except possibly at n equal to infinity or n equal to minus infinity. X of n is finite amplitude for all other values of n. You can see, except at n equal to infinity, 2 power n is always finite, right? When n less than infinity. And similarly, that minus infinity case, the minus infinity case corresponds to x of n equal to minus 2 power n into u of minus n minus 1. Implies, yeah, what is the z transform for this? X of z equals to? Okay, I have done a mistake here. Yeah. What is the transform for this? Let me consider 1 by 2 whole power n, u of minus n minus 1. This is also 1 by 1 minus 1 by 2 z power minus 1 with mod z, this left sided sequence, right? Mod z less than 1 by 2. That's what we are going to get. Here, we have the transform for this one. But when coming to n equal to minus infinity, x of n as n tends to infinity equals to, for n equals to minus infinity, this is nothing but minus 1 by 2 whole power minus infinity. Whole power infinity, right? This is nothing but minus 2 power minus infinity. Oh, this is minus infinity, right? As n tends to minus infinity, you want to see. This left side, as n tends to minus infinity, it will become minus 1 by 2 whole power minus infinity. See, for n equal to minus infinity, also this is 1, right? U of minus n minus 1. 2 power minus of minus is plus. 2 power minus 1 whole power minus infinity. Equals to minus infinity, right? That's why we mentioned this exception. Except possibly at n equal to infinity or n equal to minus infinity. X of n is finite always. Except these two locations. It's allowed. We are going to look into such examples only when we are discussing about properties of ROC of the transform. So property one, ROC will either be of the form moderate greater than RR greater than or equal to zero, or moderate less than RL, which is less than or equal to infinity, or in general, annulus. Annulus means that ring. Zero less than or equal to RR less than moderate less than RL less than or equal to infinity. Yeah, let's have a look into these ones. Let me try to give some examples of the things. X of n equals to 2 power n u of n implies that x of z, this is a right sided sequence, the right sided sequence, x of z equals 1 by 1 minus 2 z power minus 1 with mod z greater than 2, mod z greater than 2. Here the pole is at z equal to 2, right? If I equate this denominator to 0, I'm going to get z equals to 2. Pole at z equals to 2. And my ROC is outside of this one. See my ROC, I'm going to get the ROC, mod z greater than 2, right? This corresponds to mod z equal to 2 circuit. Mod z greater than 2, excluding pole. ROC won't include pole, right? At pole, z equals to 2, mod z is 2, right? But ROC means margin greater than 2. Pole will exclude that pole. That ROC will exclude that pole. With 0. See, margin equal to 2. This is my ROC. Yeah, this is one of them, right? Margin greater than RR. This notation R corresponds to right sided sequence. This capital R. So that we are comfortable with that, right? Margin greater than RR. R means right side, capital R means greater than or equal to 0. Just an example, right? Here, mod z greater than RR. Right sided sequence. Right sided sequence, right? Here, RR equals to 2. In this example, RR equals to 2 here. This is one way. And another one is, that can be a left-sided sequence. For example, consider x of n equals to 2 power n minus u of minus n minus 1 implies x of z equals to, this is a left-sided sequence. See, 1 by 1 minus 2 z power minus 1 with mod z less than 2. Mod z less than 2. Here I have pole at once again z equal to 2. And my ROC is mod z less than 2. Mod z less than 2 means that inside of this circle mod z equal to 2. This circle is mod z equal to 2. Mod z less than 2 means inside of this circle, right? This is my ROC, which excludes pole at z equal to 2, mod z equal to 2. Excluding this one, right? Is my ROC. Here I can call it like mod z less than RL. It's left sided sequence, right? Left sided sequence, this one. Less than R equals to infinity. This can be of this form also, ROC. Okay, that margin can be less than RL. This is my ROC for that one left sided sequence. C for left sided sequence, right? And when that is both sides, both sided, two sided sequence, I may expect something like a ring, right? Yeah, this one you need to answer. Can someone tell me what is the Z transform for this 2 power n u of n minus 3 power n u of minus n minus 1. Yes, what is the answer for this? You can apply linearity property. Yeah, what is the answer for this part?
1 by 1 minus 2 z inverse.
Yes, 2 z inverse.
Plus 1 by.
Okay, with R or C for this part. Mod z.
Mod z greater than 2.
Yeah, and plus 1 by.
1 by.
Yes, 1 minus 3 z power minus 1.
Mod z less than 3.
It's mod z less than 3. This is AND operation. Intersection, right? Implies ROC for this is mod z from 2 to 3. It's a ring kind of thing we are going to get. It's ROC for this. This z plane, real part, imaginary part. I have pole at z equal to 2 and I have pole at z equal to 3. If you simplify this expression, just add them. We will get P of z by Q of z kind of thing. Or P of z inverse by Q of z inverse. Like that you are going to get. And if you equate denominator to 0, you are going to get pole set z equal to 2 and z equal to 3. And ROC will exclude poles because at pole we have x of z which is diverging, right? X of z equal to infinity at poles. And the ROC between 2 to 3, mod z 2 to 3. This is my ROC. This is a ring, right? Ring kind of thing. And if you try to map to this notation, between RR to RL. Between RR to RL means, let me call this like RR. Let me call this like RL. This is left-sided. This is left-sided sequence, right? And this is for right-sided. This is right-sided sequence, right? Like that again, then. It's a two-sided sequence. Two-sided sequence. Because we have both right-sided and left-sided. Okay, at least we are able to match that somehow, this one. It's a property 2. The Fourier transform of x of n converges absolutely if and only if ROC of z transform of x of n includes the unit circle. That should include unit circle, right? According to our theory, x of z equals to sigma n equals to minus infinity to plus infinity, x of n z power minus n. And if you want absolutely converging or absolute convergence of this sequence, mod x of z should be less than infinity, right? For convergence. It means sigma n equals to minus infinity plus infinity mod x of n into mod z power minus n should be less than infinity. This should be less than infinity. And we already know the for uniform convergence of DTFT. We need this condition, right? For DTFT, uniform convergence or absolute convergence. For uniform convergence of DTFT, that x of n should be absolutely summable. This we already saw in DTFT. From this to this, if you want to justify, if mod z equal to 1 is part of ROC, this can be written like this. If mod z equal to 1 is part of ROC, then 1 power minus 1 is 1, right? This tends to 1 for mod z equal to 1. Then this condition is same as your DTFT condition. It means for convergence of, uniform convergence of DTFT for x of n, mod z equal to 1 should be part of ROC of your x of z, right? That is required. Mod z equal to 1 should be part of ROC. And ROC cannot contain any poles. This is one more property. The reason is, at poles, there's a definition of pole, right? At pole, x of z equal to infinity. This diverging. Property 4, if x of n is a finite duration sequence, that is a sequence that is 0 except in a finite interval, then ROC is the entire z plane except possibly at z equal to 0 or z equal to infinity. Let's have a look into some examples for this. Let me consider x of n equals to delta of n plus delta of n minus 2. Yeah, what is the transform for this? You can simply go to basic definition, right? Into z power minus n. Yeah, what is the transform for this?
1.
What is the transform for this?
Z power minus
2. Yes, z power minus 2, right? 1 plus z power minus 2. Okay, the ROC for this one is entire z plane except at which point?
Fine.
Plus 1 by z square except at z0, right? Can you look into this? At z equal to 0, at z equal to 0, this will be infinite, right? We have poles at z equal to 0. If we equate this one to 0, z square equal to 0, implies z equal to 0. We have pole at z equal to 0. And at z equal to 0, this is infinite, right? Divide by 0, this is infinite. This means except z equal to 0, this is 2, right? Except at z equal to 0, the entire z plane. That's my ROC for this. If you want, you can substitute any z value other than z equal to 0. This is always finite. Even if you want, you can keep z equal to infinity. 1 plus infinity whole power minus 2 is 0, right? Infinite power minus 2 is 0. 1, that's finite, right? And let me have, instead of this one, delta of n plus delta of n plus 2. Then my x of z equals 2. Z square, 1 by z square. Now what about ROC? Excluding z0 or z infinity? Excluding mod z equal to infinity. Excluding mod z equal to infinity. Because if mod z equal to infinity, this will be infinite, right? This should be finite for convergence. Other than mod z equal to infinity, you can keep any value you want. For example, z equal to 0. This is 1, right? Finite. So converge for any value of z except mod z equal to infinite case. Yeah, when that is finite duration sequence, the other things we are going to observe. Finite duration sequences. You have length only 2, right? Length of this. Or 3. You can measure 3. If you include that 0 also, delta of n plus 1. Hey, the length is infinite, right? Infinite length. It's not finite duration sequence. It's also of infinite length, infinite duration. Property 5. If x of n is right-sided sequence, that is the sequence that is 0 for n less than n1 less than infinity, the ROC extends outward from the outermost finite pole in x of z to one possibly including z equal to infinity. See, the example for this is, let me consider x of n equals to 2 power n u of n plus 3 power n u of n. Okay, z left-sided sequence, right-sided or two-sided, this sequence. Is this sequence left-sided, right-sided or two-sided?
Right-sided.
Right-sided, right? This is extending till n equal to infinity. This has extending till n equal to infinity. And they are starting at n equal to 0. They are not going till minus infinity, right? This is right-sided sequence. Right-sided sequence. And if I found x of z for this, see 1 by 1 minus 2 z power minus 1 plus 1 by 1 minus 3 z power minus 1 with mod z greater than 2 intersection mod z greater than 3 implies my ROC is mod z greater than 3. When this is a right-sided sequence, then I got my ROC, which is right side of rightmost pole. I have two poles, one pole at z equal to 2, another pole at z equal to 3. If you want clarity, you can simply add these two terms. If you add these two terms, we are going to get 1 minus 3 z power minus 1 plus 1 minus 2 z power minus 1 divided by the multiplication of both, right? 1 minus 3 z power minus 1. Let's check whether any cancellations are there or not. There are no cancellation. You have poles at z equal to 2 and pole at z equal to 3, right? And according to this statement, according to this, that should be outside of mod z equal to 3. This is my ROC. This ROC I am going to get. Which is outside of outermost pole, right? Outermost pole is 3 in this case. When that is a right-sided sequence, the ROC is right side of rightmost pole. No, not right side, outside of outermost pole. Right side means I will see one in this part, right? Outside of outermost pole. Mod z greater than 3. And there are some cases where z equal to infinity won't be part of that one. Yeah, we can see that in some examples. When coming to left sided sequence, yeah, this is vice versa for that one. Can someone answer this? Minus 2 power n u of minus n minus 1 minus 3 power n u of minus n minus 1. And z transform for this one is, this is 1 by 1 minus 2 z power minus 1 minus 1 by, oh, plus 1 by 1 minus 3 z power minus 1. With ROC for this, what is the ROC for this? Mod z less than 3. Those are left sided, right? Implies mod z less than 2. This is my final ROC. This corresponds to inside of innermost pole. Either you can think, right? I have pole at z equal to 2, I have pole at z equal to 3. See, don't think that I am considering only real poles. You can have poles somewhere here also. It depends on example. Pole can be complex also. That need not be real all the time. Mod z less than 2. This is my ROC. Mod z less than 2. It means inside of this innermost pole, this side, right? Inside of innermost thing. And this is left sided sequence. When there is left sided sequence, I can have such kind of things. And z equal to 0 may not be part of ROC. It depends on example. In this example, it's okay. And property 7, a two sided sequence is an infinite duration sequence that is neither right sided nor left sided. This is both sided, right? Fix up any two sided sequence. ROC will consist of ring in z plane bounded on the interior and exterior of a pole and consistent with property 3, not containing any poles. Because that pole is infinite, right? One example for this, x of n equals to 2 power n u of n minus 3 power n u of minus n minus 1. Let me take plus. Okay, just for my convenience, so that, see, if I keep on writing always minus, you will stick to that one. That's why I changed this one. Can someone tell me what is x of z for this? 2z power minus 1. And what should be this? Is it minus or plus?
Minus,
right? Okay. Minus 1 by 1 minus 3 z power minus 1 for this mod z greater than 2 and this left sided sequence mod z less than 3 implies my ROC is 2 to 3 mod z between 2 to 3, right? This is a two sided sequence. This is two sided, right sided and left sided also, right? This is a two sided sequence. For two-sided sequence, we got finally like this, right? Z equal to 2, z equal to 3. These are my poles between 2 to 3. And excluding pole is not equal. There is no equality here, right? Yeah, such thing you can observe for this. The ROC must be connected region. ROC must be connected region means, okay, I'll give some example. Let me consider pole at 1, pole at 2, pole at 3, and pole at 4. You can't find ROC as follows. Let me write some other way. Yeah, these are circles, but yeah, I am unable to draw properly. Margin equal to 4, margin equal to 3, margin equal to 2, margin equal to 1. We can't find ROC without any connection. This is my ROC and this is also my ROC together. We can't find like that. It's false. This is not feasible. You can't have an ROC like this. That is connected. Hey, this is disconnected, right? You can see there is no connection between this one and this one. That should be connected. As per rule, ROC won't include poles. That's why I have drawn some examples like this. This is false. This kind of ROC won't exist. If you want clarity over this, let me give example for that. X of n equals to 1 power n u of n. 1 power n means 1, right? Plus 2 power n u of n minus 3 power n u of minus n minus 1. After that, minus 4 power n u of minus n minus 1. Yeah, then what is my ROC? One plus z power minus 1 plus 1 by 1 minus 2 z power minus 1 plus 1 by 1 minus 3 z power minus 1 plus 1 by 1 minus 4 z power minus 1 with an ROC margin greater than 1 intersection margin greater than 2 intersection margin less than 3 intersection margin less than 4. And what is my final ROC? Can someone answer?
1, 2, 4.
Oh, 1, 2, 4. Is it true? It's an intersection, right? There should be intersection. Margin greater than 1 and margin greater than 2 implies.
Margin greater than.
Yeah, these two implies margin greater than 2, right? And these two implies?
Margin less than 3.
Margin less than 3, right? Then these two implies? 2 to 3, right?
Yes, sir.
Between 2 to 3. Like this, you can expect. You can try anything. You can't find that kind of disconnected regions. If you want, you can change this as left sided, make it like right sided. All combinations you can try. If there is some ROC, definitely that is connected. Otherwise, there won't be ROC. Like that you can find. For example, if I try this, instead of this, let me go with this. Then, this will become like margin greater than 4, right? Margin greater than 4. Then, will you find any ROC for them? Is any ROC with this? Margin greater than 1? And margin greater than 2 implies margin greater than 2. Margin greater than 2 and margin greater than 4 implies margin greater than 4. Margin greater than 4 and margin less than 3. Is there any intersection between them? Less than 3, more than 4. Nothing is there, right? It means there is no ROC at all. If ROC is there, by default, that is a connected. Such kind of disconnected thing we can't expect. Yeah, that's property 8. Okay, what are the possible ROCs for the below pole zero plot? Yeah, just for your convenience, I'll try to do this. Let me consider unit circle. Thinking of it like mod z equal to 1, unit circle, z plane, convex z plane. And let me consider I have poles at z equals to 0.7. And I have a pole at z equal to 0.2. Thereafter, I have a pole at z equal to 2. I have three poles. I have pole at z equal to 0.2, 0.7, and 2. This is a scenario we have. Let me consider this corresponds to h of z, where h of z is the z transform of h of n. Let me consider like this. And h of n is impulse response of LTA system. Some LTA system. Let me consider like this. Okay, for a stable LTA system, what we need to satisfy? H of n is given to you, impulse response. For a stable LTA system, what should be that thing? Inverse of this. Sigma, this should be absolutely summable, right? Impulse response should be absolutely summable. Sigma n equals to minus infinity plus infinity, mod x of n should be finite. Then you can say it's a stable LTA system. Number one. Number two, for a causal LTA system, yeah, what should be the condition for causal LTA system? H of n equal to zero for what values?
N less than zero.
N less than zero.
For n less than zero, this should be zero, right? For causal LTA system, it should be satisfied. H of n equal to zero for n less than zero. N less than. Okay, n less than zero, right? H of n equal to zero for n less than zero. The causal LTA system. See for stable LTA system. Implies mod z equal to 1 e in ROC. Is it true or false? See my claim. If that is absolutely summable. Absolutely summable means DTFT.
Exist,
right? Implies mod z equal to 1 is in ROC. That's by default true, right? Mod z equal to 1 is part of ROC. It means mod z equal to 1 is part of ROC for this transfer function H of z. Then I can say that is a stable system. If mod z equal to 1 is part of ROC, I can say it's a stable system. When coming to system, when there is a system transfer function H of z. Now what about this? I'll ask a question. Can a left sided sequence or two sided sequence be a causal system? Is it true or false? For example, consider h of n equals to minus 2 power n u of minus n minus 1. Is it causal or non-causal? Left sided, right? Is it causal or non-causal? See, causal sequence means, causal system means अच्छा अपन शुड बी जीरो पर एन लेस देन जीरो, बट दिस इज इट जीरो पर एन लेस देन जीरो? दिस इज इक्वल टू वन फॉर ऑल एन लेस देन जीरो, दिस थिंग, दिस पार्ट. इट मीन्स फॉर एन इक्वल टू माइनस वन दिस विल बिकम माइनस टू पावर माइनस वन, फॉर एन इक्वल टू माइनस टू दिस विल बिकम माइनस टू पावर माइनस टू, विच आर नॉन जीरो, राइट? हेयर फॉर एन ग्रेटर दैन इक्वल टू जीरो दिस इज जीरो, but we want for n less than 0 that should be 0. It's not 0, right? You can say this is not a causal, the non-causal system. Non-causal system. And what about two-sided sequence? Is it causal or non-causal?
Non-causal.
Non-causal, right? Because that contains left-sided also. The combination of left-sided and right-sided. Left sided means by default that is non zero for n less than zero. That's till, that will go till minus infinity, right? They are not causal. These are non causal by default. These two are non causal systems. The only scope we have is right sided. If that is a right sided sequence, then that can be causal, right? What about this? Is it causal or non causal? Which are many questions? It's right sided sequence. Is it causal? Causal, right? For n less than 0, this is 0. But we can't say that all right-sided sequences are causal. Some of them may not be non-causal. Let me consider example like this. H of n equals to delta of n plus 1 plus 2 power n u of n. Just for my example sake. Yeah. If I consider like this one, is it right-sided sequence? Is it right-sided or left-sided? Right sided means that should start somewhere at finite index n. At n equal to minus 1, this is not 0, right? Starting somewhere here. And this exponential sequence will go till n equal to infinity. It's right sided, right? 2 power 0 is 1. And 2 power 1, 2 square, and so on. Like this. It will extend, right? This kind of sequence. This is a non-causal due to this one. It's non-zero, right? But this is a right-sided sequence. This is going till infinity. It's not going till minus infinity. That's why this is a right-sided sequence. And this is not a causal system. Okay, that thing you can remember. All right-sided sequences need not be causal, right? Okay, at least, yes, let's go back to here. Can you answer what are the possible ROCs here based on properties? We have discussed the properties, right? That should be connected. ROC should be connected. You can't find like margin less than 0.2 and margin greater than 2. That's not true, right? Yeah. Can you just tell me the possible ROCs? And that should not include a pole. Okay, one possible ROC is when all of them are left-sided sequences. When all of them are left-sided sequences, then my ROC is inside of innermost pole, right? This is my ROC when all of them are left-sided. When all three are left-sided, my H of n will be left-sided sequence. H of n will be left-sided sequence, and I'm going to get like this. H of n is left-sided implies ROC is left side of inside of innermost pole margin less than 0.2. This is one possible ROC. When all are right sided sequences, then what about ROC? When all are right sided, then what is the possible ROC?
Rightmost pole margin greater than 2.
Yes, margin greater than 2, right? That's fine. When that is two-sided, okay, let me change the color. Two-sided. Can you give me some example for two-sided ROCs in this case? That can be some ring, right? That can be
Yes.
some ring. Yeah.
0.7 greater than mod z less than 2 or
Yeah.
0.2 mod.
Yes, it's fine. There are two possibilities, right? This is for my right sided case, red color one. Now, this yellow color one, one possibility yeah, that you said is 0.722. One possible ROC we are going to get is between 0.7 and 2, like the second half. This is one possible ROC, right? Which is not including any pole. By default, pole is not part of ROC. You can see all these cases. Nowhere pole is part of ROC in all those cases. You can cross check. This is one possible ROC. Oh, this is 0.722, right? 0.722. And is there any other possible ROC? Yeah, as you said, 0.2 to
0.7.
0.2 and? No, sir, 0.7 includes then.
No, it won't include, right? 0.2 to 0.7. See, if I say like this is right sided, this is right sided means mod z greater than 0.2. And if I say this is left sided, mod z intersection with mod z less than 0.7. And if I say this is also left sided, margin less than 2, margin less than 0.7, margin less than 2 implies margin less than 0.7. These two implies margin less than 0.7. Intersection with this is possible, right?
Yes, sir.
0.2 less than margin less than 0.7. These are the two possible two sided ROCs, this one and this one. These are two possibilities. Okay. Yeah, I'll try to summarize that. First possibility, left sided in this particular example, ROC is mod z less than 0.22. And second one is right sided sequence. We have two, right? Pole. Yeah. Mod z greater than 2. And third one is two sided. A two-sided, we got two sub-cases, right? 0.722. And another case, R. This is R. This is one case. And another case is 0.2 less than, mod z less than 0.7. No way pole is included in your ROC. Like that, you can have, right? Okay, which one corresponds to stable LTA system? I want stable LTA system. See, whatever we discuss, everything corresponds to H of Z. H of Z is the transfer function. For stable LTA system, what are the cases? Let me have numbering for this also. Number 3, this is number 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. For stable LTA system, yeah, what is the required condition in terms of ROC?
Unit circle.
Yes, unit circle should be part of ROC, right? Mod z equal to 1 should be part of ROC. Yeah, which one includes ROC? Which ROC includes mod z equal to 1 here?
Third case, sir.
This third case,
first case two.
This failed, right? This also failed. And this includes margin equal to 1, right? This includes margin equal to 1. This third case, this also not including margin equal to 1. That means we have only one stable LTA system. Okay, is it causal or non-causal? Is it causal?
Non-causal.
Why this is non-causal?
Two-sided sequence.
Yeah, due to this, right? Due to this part. It's left-sided sequence, right? Due to this part, it's non-causal. Okay, which of them is causal?
second one.
Yes, the only thing is second one. That should be right sided, right? It's the only causal system we have. But this is unstable. This is a causal system, but unstable. This is a stable system, but this is not a causal. It means we can't implement that practically, right? And that's a non-causal system. Except if you go with some buffers, some delayed devices. Yeah.